Google just launched its Gemini AI model. Want to try it out for free? A version of the model, called Gemini Pro, is available inside of the Bard chatbot right now. It's the beginning of a new era of AI at Google, says CEO Sundar Pichai, the Gemini Era. Gemini is Google's latest large language model, which Pichai first teased at the I.O. Developer Conference in June and is now launching to the public. To hear Pichai and Google DeepMind CEO Demis Hassabis describe it, it's a huge leap forward in an AI model that will ultimately affect practically all of Google's products. Only a sliver of Gemini is currently available. Future releases are expected to include audio and video capabilities, where a chatbot processes multiple forms of input and produces outputs in form of visuals and speech. Just the text-based version has been added to Bard for now. Demis Hassabis says Gemini is a new breed of AI. Google's new AI model Gemini launched recently inside the Bard chatbot. It could go on to advance robotics and other projects, says Hassabis. Gemini is also only available in English, though Google plans to roll out support for other languages soon. As with previous generative AI updates from Google, Gemini is also not available in the European Union, for now. Despite the premium-sounding name, the Gemini Pro update for Bard is free to use. With ChatGPT, you can access the older AI models for free as well, but you pay a monthly subscription to access the most recent model, GPT-4. Details on plans for Gemini remain scarce. Google teased that its further improved model, Gemini Ultra, may arrive in 2024 and could initially be available inside an upgraded chatbot called Bard Advanced. No subscription plan has been announced yet, but for comparison, a monthly subscription to ChatGPT Plus with GPT-4 costs $20. How to access Google's Gemini Pro? Do you already have a Google account? Using Gemini inside of Bard is as simple as visiting the website in your browser and logging in. Google does not allow access to Bard if you are not willing to create an account. Users of Google Workspace accounts may need to switch over to their personal email account to try Gemini. Remember that all of this is technically an experiment for now, and you might see some software glitches in your chatbot responses. One of the current strengths of Bard is its integration with other Google services when it works. Tag a Gmail in your prompt, for example, to have the chatbot summarize your daily messages, or tag a YouTube to explore topics with videos. Our previous tests of the Bard chatbot showed potential for these integrations, but there are still plenty of kinks to be worked out. The different Gemini versions. Gemini is more than a single AI model. There's a lighter version called Gemini Nano that is meant to be run natively and offline on Android devices. The smaller version of the AI model is fitted to work as part of smartphone features. Thanks to this version, Pixel 8 Pro users now have a few new features like sending WhatsApp replies. There's a beefier version called Gemini Pro that will soon power lots of Google AI services and is the backbone of Bard after Gemini's release, as Bard is now powered by Gemini Pro. Developers and enterprise customers will be able to access Gemini Pro through Google Generative AI Studio or Vertex AI in Google Cloud starting on December 13th. Pichai says the model will eventually be integrated into Google's search engine, its ad products, the Chrome browser, and more, all over the world. It is the future of Google, and it's here not a moment too soon. And there's an even more capable model called Gemini Ultra. That is the most powerful LLM Google has yet created and seems to be mostly designed for data centers and enterprise applications. According to Google, Ultra is its most capable mode and is designed to handle complex tasks across text, images, audio, video, and code. With all this said and done, let's just get to the important question, shall we? Is Gemini a stronger AI model than OpenAI's latest release, ChatGPT-4? OpenAI launched ChatGPT a year and a week ago, and the company and product immediately became the biggest things in AI. Google was the company that created much of the foundational technology and has called itself an AI-first organization for nearly a decade. It was embarrassingly caught off guard by how fast OpenAI's tech has taken over the industry. However, Google is finally ready to fight back. This has very clearly been on Google's mind for a while. We've done a very thorough analysis of the system side by side and the benchmarking, Hassabis says. Google ran 32 well-established benchmarks comparing the two models, from broad overall tests like the multitask language understanding benchmark to one that compares two models' ability to generate Python code. I think we're substantially ahead on 30 out of 32 of those benchmarks, Hassabis says, with a bit of a smile on his face. Some of them are very narrow, some of them are larger. So Google openly explains how Gemini beats GPT-4 in 30 out of 32 benchmarks. If this is true, Gemini beats ChatGPT with quite a margin. For years, Pichai and other Google executives have waxed poetic about the potential for AI. Pichai himself has said more than once that AI will be more transformative to humanity than fire or electricity. In this first generation, the Gemini model may not change the world. Best case scenario, it might just help Google catch up to OpenAI in the race to build great generative AI. Worst case scenario, Bard stays boring and mediocre, and ChatGPT keeps winning. Pichai, Hassabis, and everyone else at Google seem to think this is the beginning of something truly huge. The web made Google a tech giant. Gemini could be even bigger. While all the updates and news coming from Google's headquarters sounds pretty promising, given the latest scandal about their fake Gemini video, we're not sure if we're buying all of it just yet. This is all for today, dear viewers. Click like, subscribe, and ring that YT bell to stay up to date with the latest AI buzz.